nothing else, Colonel. We brought enough beef for White Buffalo's people to get by. I'll deliver the rest at the weekend if it's all right with you and with White Buffalo.
Chisholm's word.
I am not interested in your opinion of Mr. Chisholm's word. Now, sir, I understand your problem, but you have to understand mine.
Do you mind explaining?
There are many problems attendant to running a territory as large as this one. I don't propose to dwell on them here and now.
Well, what do you propose to do here and now?
I've already done it. When I heard what happened to your cattle, I made arrangements for the delivery of another herd. At a very good price.
Didn't take you very long.
I have to do what I feel is right for the army and for the territory.
All right, Colonel, you don't have to put it in triplicate. I get the idea. My Buffalo.
Sergeant Braddock will escort you back to the reservation.
That is all, White Buffalo.
Sergeant.
Yes, sir.
Straight away.
All right, follow me.
Choose him.
Into the wagon, into the wagon. Hey, Indian!
Chisholm, this changed nothing between us.
You heard the Colonel, Blankethead, straight away.
Just a minute, Sergeant. You know who you're talking to?
Looks like an Indian to me.
He's a prince of the Comanche Nation.
I don't care if he's a king of Romania. The Colonel said straight away. Let's move it.
Hold on, Sergeant. Have a cigar.
Huh?
Have a cigar.
Don't mind.
One other thing you ought to know, Sergeant. You touch White Buffalo again and I'll kill you.
Sergeant, we go now.